大多故事是由嚼通天海鲜酒家特约赞助播出。
加拿大当地时间7月4日上午，2017四川省安大略省经贸合作论坛在多伦多举行，来自中国、加拿大多家商协会、社团、媒体等单位的代表出席活动。作为在此经贸合作论坛上标志性的签约项目，中国泰和集团董事局主席王仁果与加拿大皇后金融集团董事长蒋志成在合作协议上签字，这标志着中国泰和集团国际化战略版图再获新突破。
这次呢是泰和集团与皇后金融一个合作这样一个新的一个机会。那么这次呢，这个泰和国际呢是咱们四川的一家知名的企业，他们在国内的从四川到北京到香港，现在这次到北美，所以呢把北美的合作和我们皇后金融这个强强联手，今后主要是在金融、教育、文化旅游、农业、健康、房地产这几个领域进行这个深入的合作。
觉得为什么选择这个泰和这个公司？
对，有几个原因。第一呢，这个泰，因为我是来自四川，所以呢，这个那么泰和也是从四川开始发展的一家企业，当然现在是全国全球这样一个布局。那么因为是四川家乡的企业，由于各种原因缘分，所以大家走到一起。第二，泰和呢是一个在国内呢也是非常知名的一个企业，那么他们在国内在不但企业做得好，而且他们还在扶贫，在支持贫困山区的教育方面，在回馈社区这也做了很多的事情。所以呢，还有第三呢，最主要是泰和国际的董事局主席王仁果先生是一个非常值得敬佩的年轻的企业家，那么有思想，这个有这个企业家的这种精神，所以呢，我觉得是一个很好的一个合作的一个契机和一个合作的伙伴。
嗯，那您觉得皇后作为合作对象，你们的优势是在哪里？为什么觉得泰和会选择和你们合作？
泰和呢，它现在主要的这个主业是以金融为主。那么皇后金融其实主要就是以金融为主，那么我们有加拿大的这个金融的各种牌照，比如说皇后金融有全加拿大华人金融公司当中第一个，到目前为止还是唯一一个有证监会颁发的 mutual fund dealer， 就是可以做公募市场、公募基金、共同基金这样一个面对公众的一个投资啊、融资咨询的服务。那么皇后金融还有这个私募的牌照叫 EMD，那么可以发行各种基金，对公众去融资，来对项目进行投资。还有呢，我们也有这个房地产的按揭，我们有房地产的金融，我们还有保险。所以呢，在这几个方面呢，也正好是泰和想走向国际，在国际上面找到有当地有政府颁发的资质和牌照和资源这些知名的企业进行合作，所以这也是一个非常有利的一个合作的基础和条件。
那你觉得在这途中有没有什么大的一些挑战，或者说一些难以跨越的一些合作的难点，是否有这些？
当然，这个合作大家肯定是有很多共同的目标，在这个过程当中，我们肯定是需要去不断地的这个去磨合，去努力，去共同的开拓市场，共同的理解，共同的支持，相互的信任，所以我想一切都不会是太难的。
Well, you know what? I think this is just another example of the way that foreign direct investment is finding its way to city of Markham and also to the surrounding communities. And I have to congratulate Charles Zhang. First of all, I guess wearing two hats. One is the Sino-Canada Sichuan Association, and also Queen Financial, the opportunity to attract such a big company like Taihe from China and do a partnership with them is very, very beneficial to the whole community. So I'm excited. I think it's another indication that this is the right place to do business, and this has really been the benefit of the city of Markham. We are the most diverse city in all of Canada, and that diversity has brought expertise, knowledge, and really a network globally that we now can reap the benefits from. And so I say congratulations to Charles Zhang, to Queen Financial, and I say a warm welcome to Tai He, because they're a big company in China, and the fact that we've got them here in Canada wanting to invest in our community, I think signals that this is the right place to do business.
But I do have a question. Is that the government going to raise the minimum payment, minimum rate, wage? Do you think that will affect anything?
Well, I think there is a concern out there by small businesses. There's no doubt. I've heard that from small business, that this may have an impact to their operations. And so the provincial government has chosen to raise the minimum wage in an effort to bring the quality of life up for workers out there. And like anything, sometimes there's pluses and minuses. I think overall raising the minimum wage certainly will be good for workers. I think though, some businesses they make a profit, but it's a fine line, and they have to work very hard at making that profit. And so I think for some, unfortunately, it will mean if the wage goes up, that they may not hire as many people for their particular organizations. And I know I've already heard from some small businesses they're going to have to revisit this and see how many people they can hire. So look at hopefully in a strong economy, with the economy continuing to grow, small businesses will continue to thrive. I think when we have an arrangement like this where we're seeing more investment comes into the area, that's going to provide a greater opportunity for businesses to succeed. And hopefully as that economy continues to grow, people will find the wherewithal to be able to hire more people, because as much as we are Canada's high-tech capital, we have high-tech firms, multinational head offices are located in Markham. The bulk of the employment comes from small and medium-sized businesses, and it's a key part of our economic prosperity.
感谢收看今天的大都故事，我们下期再见。